Welcome to my YouTube channel. So this video is about the Internet of Things. Upon completion of this video, you could be able to learn ano nga ba ang Internet of Things, paano nag-work ang IoT, why IoT is important, and how does this impact you? Ano ang IoT through the years, the benefits of IoT to organizations, the pros and cons of IoT or Internet of Things, consumer and enterprise IoT application, mga IoT security and privacy issue, and the future of the Internet of Things. So, yan yung magiging lesson natin sa video na to. Start natin dito sa what is Internet of Things. Ang Internet of Things, nire-refer yan to the network of physical devices or object na tinatawag na things. So, ibig sabihin, yung mga bagay na yan o yung mga object na yan is nakakonect siya within the network. So, these devices are embedded with sensors, mga electronic software, yun, may mga naka-install sa mga device na yan na mga ganun, which enable them to gather data and share it with the internet-connected devices and system without human interactions. So, yung mga devices na yan o mga object na yan o yung things na tinutukoy na yan, may mga naka-install sa kanila na mga sensors or electronics or mga software. Paano nga ba nag-work ang IoT? So, ang IoT ecosystem is consists of the web-enabled smart devices, yan yung mga things, yan yung mga object, na ginagamit or that use embedded system. So, such as kagaya ng processor, may sensor siya, may communication hardware siya, to collect, send, and act on data they acquire. So, yung mga kaya siya tinawag na embedded system kasi may parang utak na, ganyan. Kumbaga parang naging computer na, may processor, may sensor, and may communication hardware na yung mga things na yan o yung mga object na yan. So, para makapag-collect sila, makapag-send, at makapag-act sa request nung magko-control sa devices na yan or object na yon. So, ang IoT devices, nag-share the sensor data na nakokollect nila by connecting to an IoT gateway. So, ang on other edge, yung device natin where data is either sent to the cloud to be analyzed or analyzed locally. So, sometimes these devices communicate with other related devices and act on the information they get from other objects. So, the devices do most of the work without human intervention, although people can interact with the devices. For instance, to set them up, give them instruction or access to the data. So, the connectivity, networking, and communication protocol na ginagamit with these enabled or web-enabled devices largely depend on the specific IoT applications deployed. So, ang IoT can also make use of artificial intelligence na and machine learning to aid in making data collection or data processing easier and more dynamic. So, ito yung bumubuo sa kung paano nagpa-function ang IoT. Then, next, move tayo dito sa bakit important ang IoT. So, makikita naman natin dito, anything, any device, anyone, anybody could use, any service, any business, any path, any network, any place, anywhere, and anytime, any context, kayang pasukin yan ng IoT. Ang Internet of Things, tinutulungan niya yung mga tao to live and work smarter, as well as gain complete control over their lives. So, in addition to offering smart devices to automate homes, kasi nga naka-automatic na yan. Example, pauwi ka ng bahay, pwede, bago ka makauwi ng bahay, i-on mo na yung aircon, i-on mo na yung light, o kaya sabihin natin na pag may tao sa tapat ng pinto, nagla-light, or kaya nag-o-open yung camera, mga ganyan ba na pangyayari, o kaya yung ref natin, pag kinatok mo siya, mag-o-open siya, diba? Or sasabihin niya kung anong gusto mo, or pati lights, pwede mong kausapin, pwede mong sabihan yung bahay nyo, o kausapin mo yung IoT na magdilig. So, magagawa niya yun. So, ang IoT is essential to business also. Ang IoT nagpro-provide siya ng business with real-time look into how their system really work, delivering insight into everything from the performance of the machine to supply chain and logistic operations. So, ang IoT na-enables na yung mga companies to automate the processes and reduce labor costs. Pag sinabi natin labor costs, yung pasahod sa tao. Kasi, instead na tao ang nandun, yung IoT na ang tatao dun. Kasi ang IoT parang may tao sa loob. Ganun yun. So, parang may tao, may ibang nag-iisip. Parang ganyan ang nangyayari kay IoT. So, it also cuts down on waste and improves service delivery, making it less expensive to manufacture and deliver goods as well as offering transparency sa mga customer transaction. So, as such, ang IoT is one of the most important technologies of everyday life. And it will continue to pick up steam as more businesses realize the potential of connected devices to keep them competitive. Kaya soon and ngayon gumagamit na ng mga IoT ang mga businesses, and soon majority na ng mga businesses ay embrace na nila ang IoT. So paano ba, or how does this IoT impact you? So paano, anong magiging impact sa atin? So the new rule for the future is going to be anything that can be connected will be connected. But why on earth would you want so many connected devices talking to each other? Bakit gusto natin na yung mga device na yan na pwedeng mag-connect ay makaka-connect? Or makaka-connect sa isa't isa? So there are many examples of what this might look like or what the potential value might be. Sabihin natin, example natin. Ikaw ay papunta sa meeting. Ayan. So, yung sasakyan mo, may access siya sa calendar and already know the best route kung saan ka pupunta. Ano, kung may traffic or may heavy traffic, kayang sabihin ng sasakyan mo or magsasend siya ng text sa other party na inunotify na niya yung other party na yon na malilate ka kasi traffic. So, what if yung alarm clock, nag-wake up ka ng 6 a.m. and then notifies you coffee tapos ma-notify yung coffee maker na mag-brew na siya agad ng coffee for you. Diba? Ang ganda ng ganun. So, malalaman agad na, ay gumising na, gumising ka na. Matik na yung mga coffee maker mo o kaya yung kung ano man yung kailangan mag-on, yung electric fan or aircon, diba? Magsisindi sa kusina. So, what if your office equipment new? Or alam ng office mo, when it was running low on supplies, so masasabihan ka pag running low na yung supplies ninyo, or automatically, kaya niyang mag-reorder ng mas madami para ma-maintain yung supply nyo. Diba? So, paano pag, if the wearable device na ginagamit mo in the workplace could tell you when and where you were most active and productive, and isi-share niya yung information with other device that you use while working. So, on a broader scale, ang IoT can be applied to things like transportation network, o yung tinatawag na smart cities. This can help us reduce waste and improve efficiencies for things such as energy use. So, this helping us understand and improve how we work and live. The reality is that the IoT allows for virtually endless opportunities and connection to take place, so many of which we can even think of a fully understand the impact of today's ng IoT sa atin. Ano nga ba ang evolution ng Internet of Things? So this is the evolution of Internet of Things mula sa pre-internet, naging Internet of Content, naging Internet of Services siya, to Internet of People, up to Internet of Things. Nung una kasi, ang tinatawag na pre-internet is a human-to-human interaction. So, yan nangyayari yung fixed and mobile or mga telepono or SMS lang yan. Yung part ng pre-internet. So, meron tayo dyan, may smart networks or meron na tayong smart and network plus smart. And nung nagkaroon ng Internet of Content, dyan nagpakilala yung www. Pero ang ginagawa pa lang dyan is for email, for information sharing, searching, ganyan. and for entertainment. Then here comes the Internet of Services. Nung nagkaroon ng Internet Services, nagkaroon ng Web 2.0. So dyan sa may part na yan, nagkaroon na ng e-commerce or e-productivity. Then after nyan, yung naging Internet of People na. Kasi ang internet, ginagamit na siya for social media like Skype, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. Hindi na lang siya pang tinda, hindi na lang siya pang email-email na lang. Then after noon, nung Internet of People, naging Internet of Things na siya. Kasi nga, dahil kaya siya tinawag na Internet of Things, kasi using the internet, makokontrol mo yung mga object o yung mga things na merong mga sensors, may mga naka-install na software, ganyan. So, dito na pumapasok yung identification, tracking, monitoring, metering, yung mga semantically structured and shared data. So, sabi nga, mula nung smart network, naging smart IT platform services, naging smartphones and applications, naging smart devices, object and tags, hanggang sa naging smart data and ambient context. So, that is the evolution of Internet of Things. Then, ito yung IoT through the years. So, the first internet connected thing ang natatanda natin ay yung toaster ni John Romkey. So, si John Romkey is isang software engineering and early internet evangelist. Nag-build siya ng one of the 1990 show floor of Interop, a trade show for computers. So, doon niya pinakilala itong toaster na to. Si Romkey dropped a few slices of bread into the toaster and using a clunky computer, turned the toaster on. Then, it would be a decade before anyone used the phrase Internet of Things. Pero si Romkey's magic little toaster showed what a world of internet-connected things might be like. So, of course, it wasn't fully automated. A person still had to introduce the bread. So, it was part gimmick, but proof of concept and fully a preview of what was to come. So, ang Internet of Things itself was coined in 1999 by Kevin Ashton. So, nilagay niya ito sa PowerPoint presentation niya for Procter & Gamble. So, si Ashton, who was then working in supply chain optimization, described a system with sensor acted like eyes and ears of a computer. So, an entirely new way for computers to see, to hear, to touch, and interpret their surrounding. Yun yung definition niya ng Internet of Things. Then, as home internet become ubiquitous, so, and Wi-Fi is sped up, so, the dream of the smart home started to look more like reality. So, ang mga companies nagbigan sila to introduce more and more of this invention. Diyan nagpakilala yung smart coffee maker na kung saan nakakapag-brew siya ng perfect cup of coffee and oven na kayang mag-bake ng cookies with precision timing. Yung refrigerator na automatically nagre-restock ng expired milk. Yung kauna-unahan sa mga to ay yung LG's internet-connected refrigerator na hitmaker noong 2000. So, it could take stock of shelf contents, mild expiration dates, and some reasons. So, came with an MP3 player na din. So, yun yung naging feature nung ref na yun. So, nagkukos siya ng 20,000. So, as sensors become cheaper, these internet-connected devices become more affordable for more consumers. So, and the invention of smart plugs like those made by Belkin, that even ordinary object could become smart, or at least you could turn them on and off with your phone. Yung dyan na din nagpakita yung ilaw na gamit ang cellphone natin, na on and off natin, or nakokontrol natin yung ilaw. So, ang IoT system today contains a few basic components. So, una, there's the thing outfitted with sensors. So, yung mga sensors na yan could be anything na nagko-collect ng data, kagaya ng camera, inside the smart refrigerator, o kaya accelerometer na nagtatrack ng speed in a smart running shoe. So, in some cases, sensors are bundled together to gather multiple data points. So unless the thermostat contains a thermometer also, but also a motion sensor. So it can adjust the temperature of a room kapag na naramdaman niya that nobody's o walang tao doon. So nasa-sense niya yung data. So the device has some kind of network connectivity kagaya ng may Wi-Fi ito, may Bluetooth ito, may cellular or satellite, and a processor where it can be stored and analyzed. So from there, yung mga data natin can be used to trigger an action like ordering more milk when the carton is in the smart refrigerator run out, or adjusting the temperature automatically given a set of rules. So most people didn't start building an ecosystem of smart devices in their homes until the mass adoption of voice control. So nung 2014 ng Amazon introduced nila yung Echo. So isa siyang speaker with a helpful voice assistant na tinatawag na Alexa. So built-in yan. So ang Apple inintroduce niya ang Siri. So ito ay own voice assistant nila yan for 4 years prior. Pero si Siri live in your phone. Si Siri nabubuhay siya sa cellphone natin. Si Alexa nabubuhay siya sa speaker natin na could control all of the smart devices in your houses. So positioning a voice assistant as a centerpiece of the smart home had several effects. Una, it demi-satisfied the Internet of Things for consumers and encouraged them to buy more internet-enabled gadget and encourage developer to create more skills or IoT commands for this voice assistant to learn. Siyempre. The same year doon, the Amazon debuted Alexa. Apple came out with HomeKit. Itong HomeKit na to ay isang system designed to facilitate interaction between Apple-made smart devices and sending data back and forth to create a network. So, these unifying voices have shifted the landscape way from single-purpose automations and towards a more holistic system of connected things. So, tell the Google Assistant good night, ganyan. For example lang yun, ano. And then the command can dim the light. So, lock the front door. Set the alarm system. And turn on your alarm clock. So, ang LG Smart ThinQ platform connects many home appliances so you can select a chocolate chip cookie recipe from the screen of your smart fridge and it will automatically preheat the oven. Ano? And manufacturer bill this as the future. So, but it's also a convenient way to tell more IoT devices. If you already have an Amazon Echo, you might as well get some stuff for Alexa to control. Nung 2014, the number of internet-connected devices would surpass the number of people in the world. Yan, so si David Evans, yung former chief futurist at Cisco, na-estimate niya na 2015, an average of 127 new things are connected to the internet every second. So ngayon, meron ng 20 billion connected things in the world, according to estimate from Gartner. So, the excitement around the brave new interconnected world has been much with concern. So, all of these objects brought to life like Pinocchio. So, have made the world easier to control. You can let the delivery man in the front door or change the temperature inside the house all with a few taps on your smartphone. So, yan yung nangyari kay IoT hanggang nung 2016, nagkaroon ng Mirai yung botnet infects over 600,000 IoT devices with malware or nagkaroon ng virus or ng worm. And nung 2020, the number of internet-connected devices by some estimate nag-exceeds na ng 20 billion. Ano nga bang benefit ng IoT sa organization? So kasi ang Internet of Things offers several benefits sa organization. So some benefits are industry specific and some are applicable across multiple industries. So some of the most common or common benefits of IoT enabled to businesses are: una, namo-monitor yung overall business processes. Pangalawa, na-improve yung customer experience. Pangatlo, nasa-save ang time and money. Pang-apat, na-enhance yung employee productivity. and i-integrate and adapt business model and make better business decision and generate more revenue. Kasi ang IoT kasi, ina-encourage ang mga company to rethink the way they approach their business and give them the tools to improve their business strategy. Generally kasi ang IoT is most abundant in manufacturing, transportation, and utility organization, kaya making use of sensors and other IoT devices. So however kasi, it has also found use case for organizations within the agriculture, infrastructure, and home automation industry, leading some organization toward digital transformation. Ang IoT can benefit farmers sa agriculture by making their job easier also. Yung mga sensor natin na nagko-collect ng data on rainfall, humidity, yung temperature ng soil content, as well as other factors na pwede makatulong sa mga farmers natin to create new techniques. And ang ability to monitor operations surrounding infrastructure is also a factor that IoT can help with. Ang sensors, for example, could be used to monitor events or changes with structural buildings, yung bridge, and other infrastructure. So, this bring benefit with it such as cost saving, save time, quality of life, yung ng workflow changes, and paperless workflow. So, ang another is the home automation business can utilize IoT to monitor and manipulate mechanical and electrical system ng mga building. So, broader scale, yung smart cities can help cities and reduce waste and energy consumption. So, ang IoT touches every industries, including business, healthcare, finance, retail, and manufacturing. Ganun ang IoT. Pero, ano nga ba ang maganda at pangit kay IoT? So, ang kagandahan kay IoT is the ability to access information from anywhere and anytime sa device ninyo. Na-improve niya yung communication between connected electronic devices. Natatransfer mo yung mga data packets over a connected network na kung saan makakapag-save ka ng time and effort. Yung kagaya ng utusan mo, mag-on yung aircon, di ba? Pagpa-uwi ka. So, instead na bilisan mo umuwi o kung ano pa man yan, meron nang gagawa para sa'yo. So, automatic task helping to improve the quality of business services and reducing the need of human intervention. So, yun sinasabi ko. Then, we have here the disadvantage ng IoT. So, as the number of connected devices increase and more information is shared devices, yung potential ng mga hacker could steal confidential information also increases. So, ang enterprise may eventually have to deal with massive numbers, maybe even millions, of IoT devices and collecting and managing the data from all of those devices will be challenging also. So, if there's a bug sa system, it's likely that every connected devices will be corrupted also. And since there's no international standard of compatibility for IoT, mahirap it's difficult to devices from different manufacturer to communicate to each other. And we have here the consumer and enterprise IoT application. So, there are numerous real-world applications of Internet of Things ranging from consumer IoT and enterprise IoT to manufacturing and industrial IoT. So, yun yung tinatawag na IIoT. So, yung industrial IoT. So, IoT applications span numerous verticals including automotive, telecom, and energy. In the consumer segment, for example, smart homes that are equipped with smart thermostat, mga smart appliances, and connected heating, yung connected lighting and electronic devices can be controlled remotely by a computer and a smartphone. So, yung mga wearable devices din na may sensors and software can collect and analyze users' data, sending messages to other technologies about the users with the aim of making users' lives easier and more comfortable. So, yung mga wearable devices natin are also used for public safety. Example na yung pag-i-improve ng first responders. So, response times during emergency by providing optimized ruta pag nagbibahay kayo to a location or by tracking construction workers or firefighters' vital signs at life-threatening threatening sites. So on healthcare din, ang IoT nag-o-offer siya ng many benefits, including the ability to monitor patients more closely using analysis of data that's gathered. Ang hospital also often use IoT to complete tasks such as inventory management sa both sa pharmacy or sa medicinal instrument. Yan. So sa smart building naman, can, let's say for instance, nare-reduce niya yung energy cost using sensors na nade-detect how many occupants are in a room. Yung temperature nag-a-adjust automatically, sabihin natin yung turning the air conditioner on, ite-turn on niya yung aircon if sensors detect a conference room is full, or turning the heat down if everyone in the office has gone home. In agriculture, yung IoT-based smart farming, natutulungan silang mamonitor yung, for instance, light, yung temperature, humidity ng soil, moisture, or crop field using connected sensors. Ang IoT is also instrumental in automating yung irrigation system. And yung smart city, ang IoT sensors and deployment such as street light o yung smart street light, smart meters, na kung saan nag-help sila alleviate the traffic, nagko-conserve ng energy, monitor and address environmental concern, and improve also the sanitation. And ano nga ba yung IoT security and privacy issue? So these are the privacy issue of IoTs. Kasi ng Internet of Things, binibring niya lahat ng benefits of the internet to items, kagaya ng light bulb saka thermostat, diba? But it brings all the problem of the internet too. Ngayon ang mga tao have their speakers, television sets, may refrigerator, may alarm clock, may toothbrushes, light bulbs, doorbells, baby monitor, and security cameras connected na sa Wi-Fi. So, nearly even devices in the house can compromise or render useless. Consider natin yung whims of internet connectivity. So, when your Wi-Fi goes down, so your device, so ganun din yung mga devices ninyo and router problems. So, that means you can turn on the heat with your smart thermostat or unlock your smart door lock. So, things that used to be easy become potentially faulty. Diba? If not possible when they require an Alexa command or a smartphone control rather than a physical button. Diba? Many of these devices also run on proprietary software. So, meaning, if their manufacturer goes bank, gets sold, or stop issuing software update, your clever little gadget become a useless hunk of plastic. Yun yung nagiging risk doon. Another risk of breaking aside, diba? Connecting things to the internet also leave those objects and everything else on your Wi-Fi network more vulnerable to hacker. So, si Laura Dernadis, in her recent book na Internet in Everything, he called this threat to cybersecurity the greatest human rights issue of our time. So, the risk isn't just that some prankster break into your smart washing machine and upset the spin cycle, or that your Nest camera get hijacked with a message to subscribe to PewDiePie's YouTube channel. Oo, nangyari yan. Ano? So, a hack smart lock means someone can open your front door, hack into enough smart water heaters, and you can send a city into massive blackout. And one vulnerable device can compromise the whole network. As Ward Lily High Newman points out, ang IoT device have been conscripted into massive botnets. So, compromise for nation-state reconnaissance or hack to mine cryptocurrency and manipulated in assault on power grids. Ayan yung nangyayari. And another threat to internet-connected devices comes not just because they're connected to the internet, but because devices manufacturers have not always designed their products with security as a priority. In 2016, yung malware nga na Mirai, yung kanina, yung nasabi natin, exploit this kind of vulnerabilities sa mga 600,000 IoT devices to create a massive distributed denial of services o nag-DDoS attack sila. So, the following year, an attack called Crack naman infected nearly every internet connected devices na nakakonect sa Wi-Fi. So yung attack na yun was crippling and difficult to defend against. In part because the Internet of Things run on so many disparate operating systems. So kapag ang phone or computer natin get hit with a virus, software makers are generally quick to issue a patch. But things routers or internet connected doorbells don't usually receive software updates needed to protect against vulnerabilities, and many of them weren't built in with the same kind of security protocols as computer. So mas madaling pasukin ng mga hacker ang mga IoT gadget natin. After that, yung crack attack, one security researcher predicted that we would still find vulnerable devices 20 years from now. Then there are question of privacy. If camera and microphones are studded around your home, they're definitely watching and listening to you, 'di ba? Di mo alam na nagagawa na pala yun ng mga hackers. So everything in the Internet of Things collects data. And all that data has value. Sa, kaya nga sa recent study din, yung mga researcher na found nila na 72 of the 81 IoT devices they surveyed has shared data with a third party unrelated to the original manufacturer. So ibig sabihin nun, the finer details of your personal life as depicted by your smart toothbrush, your smart TV, or your smart speaker can be repackaged and sold to someone else. So Google and Apple both admitted last year that the recordings captured by their smart speaker are reviewed by contractors, including acquired and intimate na mga usapan, 'di ba? So Amazon has partnership with over 400 police department who use the footage from each Ring doorbell cameras to keep watch on neighborhoods. So an ever expanding Internet of Things doesn't just have consequences for personal privacy. So it can create a network of computer eyes and ears everywhere we go. Dahil nga sa IoT devices are closely connected, 'di ba? All hacker has to do is to exploit one vulnerability to manipulate all the data, rendering it unusable. So ang mga manufacturer that they don't update their devices regularly or at all, nililib nila yung mga IoT devices na yung vulnerable to cyber criminals. Additional dito, connected devices open ask user to input their personal information including yung name, age, address, ganyan, kinokollect yung mga yan, phone number, at mga social media accounts. Which is mga information na takaw mata sa mga hackers. So, mga hackers aren't the only threat to the Internet of Things. Yung privacy is another major concern sa IoT users. For instance, ang company that make the distribute consumer IoT devices could use those devices to obtain and sell users' personal data. Diba? Beyond leaking personal data, IoT possess a risk to critical infrastructure including electricity, transportation, and the financial. Yan, the transportation and the financial services. And dahil alam na natin yung mga privacy issue ng IoT, we have here now naman the future of Internet of Things. So one day, ang Internet of Things will become the Internet of Everything. So the object in our world might sense and react to us individually all the time. So parang Pinocchio na yung mga gamit na nabigyan ng buhay. So that a smart thermostat automatically adjusts based on your body temperature, or the house automatically locks itself when you get into bed. Your clothes might come with connected sensors too, so that the things around you can respond to your movements in real time. So nag-umpisa na yan in 2017 nga yung Google in-announce nila yung Project Jaguar. So an effort to create the connected wardrobe for the future. So this vision extend far beyond sa pananamit natin or even sa mga bahay natin. You'll also have smart offices, smart buildings, smart cities. Magkakaroon ng smart hospital rooms na may sensor to ensure the door wash their hands, di ba? And airborne sensors na makakatulong sa mga cities ma-predict ang mudslide and other natural disaster. Mga autonomous vehicle will connect to the internet and drive along roads studded with sensors. So, and government will manage the demands of their energy grids by tracking household energy consumption through the Internet of Things. And the growth of Internet of Things could also lead to new kinds of cyber warfare. So imagine natin a bad sector disabling the every smart thermostat in the dead of winter or hacking into internet connected pacemaker and insulin pumps, di ba? So it could create new class system, those with robot maids and those without. So as Ray Bradbury described in one short story from 1950, all the people might disappear but the smart homes preparing meals and sweeping the floor will live on. So if we're going to get there, whether we like there or not, we're going to need faster internet. Then na pumapasok si 5G. We'll also need to keep all those devices from mucking up their airwaves and we'll need to find a better way to secure the data that transmitted across those airwaves. So recently, the Swiss cryptography, yung firm si Tesseract introduced yung idea of cryptographic. So, implant of IoT devices which would protect the data and streams from these devices. So, there are also ideas for creating a better standard for IoT devices and plans to help them get along with each other. So, regardless yung of which companies makes them or which voice assistants live inside. So, yan yung IoT or the Internet of Things. Thank you for watching to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe and click on bell icon to get notification on my channel. Salamat po!